So as in the previous videos, we have seen the types of classes which were our main class and our real class. So in this video, we are going to understand the anatomy of our main class, which means we will understand in depth how our main class actually works. So welcome back folks, this is Shardul Gavande from Ace Knowledge and let's start with our session. So let me write my main class over here. I will say as public class main. Okay, and I will simply open my main class over here and close it over here. So this is my main class. So what will a general class will have? A class will have methods and variables, right? So let us declare some methods for our main class. And we'll give a name for that method as main method. So I will write here as public void, because I don't want to return anything. So that is the reason I'm writing void. And as you know that whenever your code is being executed, your main method is the method which gets called. So it should obviously not return anything. So I will write as public void main. This is the name of my method. This symbol shows that I have my method, or this is simply a method. And again, opening of my method and closing of my method. But what we know is, in order to access methods, we need to create something called as objects. So where can we create objects? Well, this is our main method and we have to create objects in order to access method. But what if I say that I don't want to create an object and simply access this method with the help of class name? Is that possible? And the answer is yes, it is possible. So if you declare your method, I repeat again, if you declare your method as static, then you don't need to create any objects for that method, objects for that class, right? So we have a method. So in order to access this method, we need to create objects of this class. But if I don't want to create any objects, then I need to declare this method as static. So I will write here as public static. Let me write the entire thing. Public static void main. And this is my opening and closing. So public static void main. So whenever your method is been declared as static, you don't need to create any objects to access this method. Okay, so this method can access with the help of simply class name. Let's say my class name is main dot and my method which is main. Class name dot your method name. This is how I can access my method if I declare my method as static. Same goes for variables. If you declare your variable as static, then you can access it directly using the class name. So why here we are declaring our method as static? Because we don't have to create objects, and whenever JVM starts executing your program, it searches for your main class under your main method. So it has to be much more faster. So that is the reason we are avoiding to create objects and declaring our method as static, so that in a faster manner our main method has been accessed, and from there whatever our other real classes methods or variables have been executed, or they have been taken into consideration to be executed. Fine. So public static void main. Now under that, let's print something. So we have system dot out dot print and into bracket let's say hello folks. So I am printing this system.out. So I am printing hello folks with the help of system.out.print. So now what exactly is this system? As we know that any class name starts with first letter as capital. So here I have system whose S is capital, which means that this is my class. Or we can say this is my predefined class. So this is my class, predefined class. Then out is my object, okay, and print is my method. So how do we access? So we have seen in the creation of objects and accessing a method using objects, we have a video on that, right? Object creation. So if you have not watched that video, I would recommend you to watch that video first, so that it is easier for you to understand this. So we have print as method. So in order to access method, what you need is object. So this is my object out, and this is my class, system predefined class. So I am accessing this method with the help of object, and here is my predefined classes, system.out.print. And if you want to print it on a new line, you just have to write print ln, and this hello folks will get on a new line. So public main class, then our main method, which is declared as static and public because it should be accessible outside the class. And this is my statement, system.out.println. System is my predefined class, out is my object, print or println is my method. And I'm accessing this method using object, and I have my system as predefined class. With the help of dot operator, I am able to access all these things, or simply this method. Closing of my method and closing of my class. So that's what is the understanding or how main class works. Whenever JVM will execute your code, it will look for the main class. Under that, your main method will get called. Because it is static, it doesn't need to create any objects to be called. And directly it will get called with the help of class name. And that's it, how we can print whatever we want to print it. Or simply here, we create our objects for real classes, right? So that was regarding anatomy of our main class. If you like the video, do hit the like button. If you have any doubts regarding this, do comment in the comment section. Share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe.